glad we're heading back to Svartalfheim.
There's work to be done. We met the ghost of a father who needs to know what became of his son. And what else? Those bloody mining rigs in the bay, for one.
Let's do it.
Leave some hands. Are some angry knives. Ought to make Odin's spear look like a toothpick. Here's the fun part. Talk for a spell?
Incoming fire!
You're on fire! But you probably already know that.
Still whine.
There are more coal raiders out there. They know it.
They fear that which can no longer hurt them.
They were only puppies when the coal raiders killed their pack. When the wolves smelled them, it was like they became those same scared pups again. Is that the helmet from Tyr's statue over there? Gathered in their home realms, waiting for when we blow Gjallarhorn. Guess I was kind of hoping to see some of them here.
When all the realm towers open at once, we'll see plenty, lad. Odin won't believe what's coming for him.
No. Odin had lifetimes to prepare for this. Whatever Groa's deception, he heard the truth as Tyr. Do not underestimate him.
Rousing speech, brother. Very inspirational.
Wow, the Valkyries look different.
Welcome back. Hilda Sfini informed me of your success. We've been planning accordingly.
Well, what would Ragnarok be without Ragnarok?
Who else agreed to join us? I see the Valkyries.
Better than that, they are reborn. Corporeal and uncorrupted, thanks to no small amount of Vanir magic. They're shield maidens now.
Nice.
And your brother?
He came through, The elves called a truce to unite against Asgard. That gives us an advantage by air, and with Hel's army for a vanguard.
What about Sindri? Will the dwarves fight?
We haven't heard from him. But there's time yet. And I think we have what we need to clear a path for the Ragnarok beast.
Well, when you say it like that, why worry at all? Sigrun! It's good to see you so... alive.
Oh, yes. I wasn't myself when last we met. I'm glad you're safe. My queen, the Shield Maidens will be divided among the forces breaching from Alfheim, Helheim, and here in Midgard. We stand ready. Kratos, Atreus, Mimir, please excuse me.
Oh. Good night, then.
Freya, have you determined our path out of Asgard?
If the towers are the way in, we count on them being the way out.
And if they are not?
Then we all know what we signed up for. Our plan is only missing one thing. A leader.
That honor is yours. You have a righteous claim. And the respect of your troops. And you have faced this enemy before.
I held his invading army to a stalemate. This is our invasion. A siege on his terrain. I want our most experienced wartime general in the field. I don't care about the honors. I don't care about the prophecies and champions. I just need us to win.
Freya.
I know what I'm asking. Just sleep on it. Here we are. Kratos, your tent is to the right, and Atreus, yours is to the left.
Mine?
A young warrior needs his own space, don't you think?
I do. Wow. Thanks.
Sleep on what we spoke of. Let me know in the morning what you decide.
Come join us.
Excuse me. May I have a moment with Mimir? I don't know what tomorrow brings, but if tonight is our last night, I'd like to spend it feeling something besides hate. Will you tell me one last silly story?
There's nothing I'd like more. Except perhaps a dance. Though I may have lost a step. Due respect, love. I don't tell silly stories.
You only tell silly stories.
I could never argue with you.
Can I sleep here tonight?
Quiet your mind.
I can't.
Then I will tell you a story.
If I fall asleep, promise you'll finish it tomorrow?
Of course. Now, close your eyes. There was an old man who chopped wood for his village. Every evening, he bore the logs on his back and delivered them to his people. But the logs were heavy, and he grew weaker as time went. And one day, he threw down the logs, as he could no longer bear their weight. And he called for death to come to him. And when death arrived,
the only one who ever got my highbrow sense of humor. Damn fine woman she was. Apart from her taste in men, of course.
She was a special woman. She wanted to protect people.
She was here. She saw every step we took before we took it. Like she was always with us, watching over us, leading us home.
My request upset you? F is a natural part of life, my love. I wish only to be prepared for when my time comes. Mortals must do such things. I am glad to have you prepare with me. we're quiet?
I have nothing to say.
Well, say something. I enjoy hearing your voice.
A funeral pyre. I would have chosen different.
Oh. You would have me trapped in the ground for eternity.
I would have you close to me.
How touching. My rotting corpse would bring you such comfort. You once tried to take charge of your ending, did you know?
That was different.
Circumstance, yes. But not on purpose.
You prepare for a distant future. There is much time ahead of us.
I wish to better a future. That will exist without me, whenever that day comes. For you, and for our son. We will always walk together, Kratos. You will always be a part of me. I will always be a part of you.
When you are gone, that part of me dies as well. Faye, do you feel your absence?
No. Culmination of love is grief. And yet we love, despite the inevitable. We open our hearts to it. When the pyre is spent, and you have gathered my ashes, spread them from the highest peak in all the realms. You will do this for me. Is to have loved fully. Open your heart to the world as you have opened it to me, and you will find every reason to keep living in it.
What's going on?
It is time.
I'll meet you outside, Father. Sir.
to battle with you one more time, my queen.
Me too. But not as your queen. As sisters. Are you ready?
Yes. I will be your general.
It will be an honor to fight alongside you, General.
Aye, brother. I'll be right by your side. So, what are your orders?
To the temple.
General.
Sir?
General?
General?
Sir.
Hey, bud. General.
I came to these lands to escape my past, to start a new life. I can hide no longer. I do not want this war. We have suffered enough. Prophecy did not lead us here. Nor will it win this battle. Wars are won by those that are willing to sacrifice everything. If that is the cost of vengeance, so be it.
Odin has taken so much from us already. The realms have suffered enough. No matter the cost. This ends today.
Going out in a blaze of glory means that Odin burns too.
Might as well be. A big fat smile on my face.
For Brock.
Yeah! Yeah!
Niflheim Tower's fallen.
If Odin goes after Niflheim next...
They're trying to shut out Ragnarok.
Gotta stop those war machines.
Not an ideal start.
We got work to do.
You three, follow. Atreus. Freya, with me. Watch our flanks. To the war machines.